So, now, do you still remember what we have learned in the LMT 100 after your 1 week break?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, so far so good. So still remember your adjectives, your adverbs. Okay, so today we are going to continue with short stories. Okay, short story. Can you take out your textbook? What is a short story? What do we have in a story? Characters. Good. Characters. Who are the characters? It could be what? It could be? It could be?
Writer.
Okay, the writer. It could be people. It could be, and could it be animals?
Yes,
it could be any subject, alright, that make up the characters. What else besides characters we will have?
Storyline.
The storyline, or we call it a, one word, starts from P, plot, good, plot, okay? The plot of the story, okay, is the storyline. It will tell us how, you know, what goes on, okay, after another, alright? And what else do we have? In a story, we normally have a theme. Good, a theme. Okay, a theme is a message. A message that the story is trying to relay or tell us. Okay, anything else in a story? How about the setting? Setting. The setting. Okay, what is the setting of a story? It could be the place, yes, the place where it took place. What else? The time, good, the time, when, okay, when it took place, right? So that is the setting, okay? So today, we are going to look at two short stories, okay? The first one is A Question of Dowry, and the next one is Can. Alright, now, I will give you some time to read, okay, silently the story, alright? We are going to do it group-based, okay, you have a pair, it's okay, you can work, okay, in twos. Okay, girls, okay, you are going to read, okay, The Question of Dowry, okay, boys, you are going to read, yes, Cat in the Dream, and boys, okay, The Question of Dowry, okay? Alright, I want you to read silently. Before later, okay, I would like you to take turns in your group to read it aloud. Okay? So read silently for a few minutes before we read it. Okay? We are going to start reading aloud. So, okay, we will start with the first story, A Question of Dowry. We will start from the girls. Okay? Take turns to read one paragraph each. Okay? And boys, you continue. And then, when you are done, back to the girls and continue until we complete the story. Okay? Alright.
There was much excitement in Mistress Ramachandran's hospital. The doctor of the house, Sivasuti, was going to be engaged. The festive air was laden with the spicy smell of stories and wigs.
Why this?
Sizzle in the quali sauce. The young lady of the house was befitted her present condition, assumed a calm pose and amidst the general bustle and noise. Mrs. Ramachandran flew her here and there as fast as her 160 pounds would allow her, and helped with her commanding suggestions.
Don't put too much coconut milk in advance. Aya, it's got to go in by stage. The last bit, the delicious part, must be kept the last. Now, let me go out and take. But don't dirty your shape. What will Uncle Jennifer think if you are dirty?
Just then, Mr. Ramachandran comes into the kitchen and bed. Beckoned to his wife. She walked out beautifully, for she managed his husband, obeying him in the little thing is such pettiness that he taught himself love for a living as best well. In Java, Mr. Roman Chandran asked his wife where she had the chain which they were giving the daughter as a personal desire. Mr. Roman Chandran went up to her cupboard and unlocked an iron basket in which were many glittery trinkets. From the mess of beauty as a heavy with many glittering winter. On the mess of 15, he expected a heavy dochen quiver.
Half
painted much a detail. She did the
side
with a content.
Children's mother and his double down his sister take the value of this necklace. I'm glad we decided to give this. It can be kept for her daughter when she gets married. Then Shelburne's mother, what a trusting woman she is. So surprising that she should be one because her husband earns so much per month. Her son is more like his father. Thank goodness. I'm sure she takes most of his salary now. But then the doctor always has a lot of the better things before giving too much to his mother now since he is going to have a family of his own soon. Oh, Ramachandra, you must have a talk with that young man sometime and give him a few helping hints on how to save for his future family. You see, he's got to realize that his sons must have a good education and that his daughters must have enough glory. This young man never realized what they should do for their future and for their families.
Well, Ramachandra, I leave all this to you. You can better everything so well, especially young people. I always say, anyway, you have done well by our doctor. $20,000 is not to be scoffed at. That's more than I can say for one. And as soon as I gave this doctor, when our son married her, and she had only passed 4-2, I was able for that match. But Arus has always been a stubborn and unfeeling boy. Although he insists on choosing his disorder or his own wife, well, that passed. Now I really must leave you. There's so much work to see.
Mr. Ramachandran had been trying to get a word in, and when his wife paused for breath, for she was really going to continue, he grabbed his chance. We have to return the necklace. Return it? Why? What will Tiruchelvan's mothers and Mr. Ramachandran raised his hand. There is something which I want to tell you for some time, but I didn't want to worry you. You can't pay for the necklace. Do you remember that land we were going to sell to get the dowry and money for the necklace?
Oh, you owe me. You want to think that we have no money for our necklace? Mr. Ramachandran, is it? Then, continuing in the tone of her tones, she inquired loudly, which piece of land do you mean? My father gave us 4 for my glory, and our second son received 3 as his wife's glory.
Come on, wife, we want to let the sister become. Children, don't be afraid. Have only one piece of ten before your daughter. It's so also of other two of forfeit and false son be ready. You ask me to live with yourself as well. I learn that with that stands that's given to him, and he already lifted it up to some household in order to get cash for his excellent needs.
Afraid of whether he was willing to reveal to the guy who gets envy and this to save the family, with Mrs. Ramchandra's name, motions to the husband who dropped the subject. However, Mr. Ramchandra continued.
About the land, I'm afraid it is impossible to sell it at a quarter of its former price. You see, water has been seeping out about somewhere for about 10 years, and so the land is not too much. For a household, unless we were to break it, no one would buy it for our son.
Are you insulting my poor father? Give me a piece of sodden land. Impossible of if he were to know what sort of son-in-law he was getting, he would have made a wiser decision. But I shall have a better son-in-law who will not depend on his wife dowry. He is a doctor, and he was his own income.
Means that she thought she's doctor. After having locked for security is his container in case. Mr. Ramachandra, worried about his son, he always found himself at his loss for work when his wife was not
eloquent. Mr. Ramachandra called to her daughter, and the ladies come beautifully for the this week for the petrol.
Masoji, you are a very lucky girl. You will have a daughter for your husband, and Mrs. Mugu will have a pig for from him. But you are so much better than her daughter. Now, Gilgam is coming in half an hour, and well, you are nicely dressed, I see. Do pick up the jasmine flowers that are two dropping on your left side. There, that's better. Both by the you move, look what you have made me do. You have made me not too off, no better. This looks better, not so crowded. He loves you very much. His father told your father so.
She was a thin, look shy, and glanced away with a modest stroke on the head. Lumbly, ill. Priyahakka, Uncle Dear Gilbert has come to see you. Priyahakka is waiting for you in the hall. I thought him you were waiting for the last 2 hours.
The two women were horrified. Mr. Ramachandra snatched the happy tummy as he danced into the room and spanked him hard. Silly boy, don't sharp those kicks. Why, your sister has been hard and worked in the kitchen this very lovely. Just because she looks too so fresh and tiny. It doesn't mean she was not working. Do you think she's so lazy as to sit and not do anything? Go out and play.
Tammy hurried off, surprised and unwilling. Silver Sophie and her mother went up into the hall when Mama, permitting herself the most modest of dances,
Pursuer,
and permitting him to sip from her numerous view of shy smells, suffered discreetly and retiringly into the kitchen.
Good morning, aunties. Say to the generation. I come to say after Norman Chandra, she went me up this morning. They sit down and I will give the bus softly with
facts.
You agree. Do this.
Do this.
If there's some good, then newly made and Chris. Siva Sumti is a flavor, but of course she added cowley and she
slightly.
You know that, sit down, make it your home. But it's not comparable to yours, of course, and how it's your dear mother. I must go and see her soon. We'll have so much to talk about. But that's not surprising. We have a some interest, and that, of course, is your happiness. And now, so sit down, and I will ask.
No, please don't bother. I'm very busy, and I must be under Ramachandran and go. You call him up, please. Mrs. Ramachandran knew when to cross the person, and she gave him with Krishna.
Please.
Well, I'm sure you have a lot to discuss, so I will get him for you. The gentleman sat down outwardly, attempting not to show his annoyance. What does his mother, her daughter's modest airs? Did Mrs. Ramachandran have them when she was young too? When a man had to have a wife, so why not have one with reasonable glory?
Mr. Ramachandran gave him his wife, and after further visitors, ordered that the path she departed for the teacher. Mr. Ramachandran then proceeded to tell his teacher's son-in-law what he had already taught his wife, really. He would have been less fed in Mrs. Ramachandran's mother, believed in this about the favorite he valued then.
After Tiruchelvan had left for his dispensary, Mr. Ramachandran had to let his wife and daughter know about the changed situation. While comment Mr. Ramachandran stoically, there is more than one doctor in our community, and it's up to you, Ramachandran. Do you do your duty as a father? Siva Sakti went into the kitchen, her head bowed modestly.
Okay, thank you. Now, boys and girls, do you understand the story? This is about what?
Dowry.
Dowry. What is a dowry?
Mascara.
Okay, a gift. Okay, a gift in exchange of, okay, marriage. Meaning, you know, in our culture, all right, there must be a gift. Okay, that you present, okay, upon agreement to marry someone. Okay, so this is in which culture, this story?
In
an Indian culture. So what can you observe in an Indian culture? Who gives the dowry?
Woman.
The woman to the man. Okay, the woman to the man. So, is there anything different to your culture?
Yes.
Tiffany, in your culture?
My country, the guy keep the girl. The man keep for the girl.
Okay, normally how much? Is it a lot?
Or is it men? Different. No more is now. Same house.
Okay, it depends. Right,
depends.
So a male will present it to the female.
Yeah.
Okay, alright. The same for the ladies. Okay? Alright. So if you look at the story, okay, the father is planning to marry the daughter to a who? What is his name? Tiruchelvan. Guru Kelvin works as a
doctor.
Alright? So in the end, okay? But what is the problem? The problem is with the dowry. What happened to the dowry? They can't afford, can they afford to pay the dowry? No, because the land that, what, whose father? That Mr. Ramachandran has is a devalued land. There is no value or less value, okay? So they can't afford to pay the dowry to Tiruchelvam. So in the end, did Tiruchelvam agree to get married? Did Tiruchelvam, the doctor, agree to get married to Sivasoti? Agree or disagree? In the last few paragraphs. Than one doctor in our community. Okay, and another word, before that, Mr. Ramachandran had to let his wife and daughter know about the change situation. Meaning, okay, the plan has changed. Okay, Tiruchelvam did not agree to get married. So, the father has to find another man. So, in an Indian culture, in this culture, okay, what do we call this marriage? Yeah? What do we call this marriage? Arranged marriage. Okay? An arranged marriage. Whereby, you know, the parents find a suitable candidate for the children to get married. Okay? This is an arranged marriage. Okay? Okay? The opposite of arranged marriage is love marriage. Okay? Where you fall in love and then, you know, you decided to get married. Okay? So no one forced you to get married. But you decided, you agree with that person whom you are in love with to get married. Okay? So, now, so if you look at the questions on page 7 and 8, okay, and 9, there are more questions to test your understanding. And even on page 7, there are words, there are glossary of words that are quite unfamiliar for you throughout the story. The first one, wadis, brown, savory, deep fried lentil cakes. So wadis, do you know this is, this is a type of Indian cuisine. Okay, very popular in Indians, okay. You can get it from Mamak's store. Okay, wadis. So, I would like you to go on, okay, to do the questions on page 7, 8 and 9 so that you will know, okay, you know, yeah, you will understand the story even more, okay? And on page 11, 12, you have Cat in the Rain. Okay, boys, do you understand the story of Cat in the Rain? What actually happened? What is the setting? It took place in a hotel. Okay. And then?
Hotel. Yeah, beach.
Who stayed at the hotel?
American.
Okay, two Americans. And what are their relationships?
husband and wife.
Husband and wife. Okay. What are the characters in the story? As the title suggested. What happened? The wife wants a cat. Oh, she saw the cat. She saw the cat from the window of her of the hotel, and she wants the cat. Right? Did she manage to get the cat in the end?
Yes.
Yes. Someone brought the cat over to her. Okay. So in the whole story, okay, what description were given about the husband and wife, their relationship?
The wife said the husband did not take care of her, is cold. It's very, very nice. Actually, she want to eat the night food, she want to wear the night bed. She want to go from bed.
Yeah.
The night is different.
But
her husband is not care.
Okay. The husband is less caring.
Less caring.
Yeah. And the husband did, the husband pay so much attention to the wife? Yes or no?
No.
No. Okay? Alright. Now, I would like, if you look at page 13 and 14, okay, and 15, there are questions. There are 10 questions regarding the story. Alright. Now, boys and girls, these two stories are very popular. If you Google them, okay, you will get more information about these two stories. I suggest, if you do not quite understand these two stories, okay, go back and Google them and read the description about the story. You know, they will write, you know, the plot, or they will tell you about the, okay, the summary of the story, so you can get a better understanding of these two stories. So what I would like you to do is, okay, when you come back this Thursday, I would like you to work in groups, okay, and to give us, you know, a short presentation in groups, okay, according to your opinion, right? There are two questions. One, in the first story, okay, right, what is your opinion about love marriages, okay, as opposed to arranged marriages? Okay, do you agree to love marriages or arranged marriages? Okay, so give your viewpoint, okay, but you can relate your example to the story. Okay, for the second story, okay, you are going to give your opinion on, okay, alright, what is most important in a relationship? Okay, in a relationship, is it love? Is it wealth? Or what? Okay, tell us, what is most important in a relationship between husband and wife? Okay, is it money? Is it love? Is it what? Okay, tell us. So you can relate, you know, your example to the examples of the story. What happened in the story? So when you give your opinion, quote examples from the story to support your opinion. Can you do that? Okay? We are going to do this when you come back on Thursday. Alright? And in the meantime, you also have to answer all the questions in the, okay, in the textbook. Yeah, as I told you, if you Google and search the story, you will get correct answers to these questions. You know, these are popular stories, so they are well known. So read up and, you know, get a better understanding of these two stories. Okay, are you all clear on what you're supposed to do?
Yes.
All right. When you come to class on Thursday, I want each individual to have an opinion. So in groups, you can discuss your, what are the points that you would like to talk about regarding the questions that I've given you earlier. Arranged marriage or love marriage, or what is most important in a husband's and wife relationship. Okay? You can have one person to talk about one point and present it on Thursday. Okay? And then on Thursday, we will talk about how to give an individual oral presentation. What do you need to do when you come to the front and speak? Okay, are you all clear? Okay, so I want you to go back and read up about this story and try to understand more about these two stories. Okay, are you all clear? Do you have questions for me? Yes or no? No. So I will see you all again on Thursday, inshallah. Okay? So thank you, boys and girls. Please, okay? Okay, go back.